So I wanted to do a book review on one of my newest additions to the collection. I got myself a copy of the Book of Artifice. Specifically, I got copy number 45. He only made 108 of them. Nines like me, apparently. It's not a storybook. It's more of a guidebook of sorts. It's a very thorough and essentially, as near as I can tell, comprehensive list of different magical techniques or methodologies. Very thorough breakdown of naming things. And I remember I finished reading it, and it goes on to talk about, what is this? This is the appendix. It just kind of sums it up. Basically, if you get a copy of this book, it would benefit you to go straight to page 70, the first appendix, and just read the remaining 10 pages. Because it will be insightful. Because most of these things are exercises, and attaining a theoretical understanding of them is nice and all, but it even says it's not meant to just be read through, per se. And I did it because I took, like, English notes, which I will send Mr. Brujo privately. But, I'm not sure. But I think that it might benefit us in this little review to read from his third appendix, which is The Argument for Magic, which is what my channel is all about. I'm trying to argue for the importance of magic. For its relative nature is around you. Number zero.
Love it.
Everything on this list can be exploited by the person who knows how. This is true. Anytime you know how a thing works, you can use the rules that you've now learned to play that game. Number nine, magic links can be formed through the use of strategically placed physical objects, possession of biological components and or byproducts and or excretions, or by emotional response. So magical links. I wouldn't use magic in the argument for magic, depending on who I'm arguing with. If I was arguing with another practitioner who's already accepted magic, we're just splitting hairs as to how the magic works, absolutely. But when he says magical links here, the uninitiated could interpret this as strange links. Things that aren't necessarily easily explained or easily observed. What fool is not so humble as to say that they know all? Is to say that there aren't things out there which I cannot see. There's plenty of things I can't see. And it just goes on for a couple of pages, which is essentially a list of things to help get the reader into into a state that is prepared to ingest this information. For instance, number 19, actions cause effects. Number 20, people can be taught. These are shown when he talks about curses or whatever. He does so rather respectfully and without that annoying, unnecessary, like, respect me because I know curses feel that some authors who write about curses give off. It's very, very much a scientific approach to it. He maintains the practicality throughout even the strange parts of it, leaving warnings, for instance, about how certain trance states or whatever are prone to absurd responses. Yes, magic is very strange, but there is a science to it. I did learn a lot from it. I liked how he talks about different herbs having things in common. Like money herbs would be things that are smoked for incense, or you actually smoke them, kind of thing, if I remember correctly. So all in all, a very handy little book to have for any artificer. type this man up an email. Y'all have a blessed one.